director on the Tonight Show, Letterman. You've seen him in his own HBO One Night Stand, all the Chris Rock flicks, and most recently alongside Jennifer Aniston and Adam Sandler movie Just Go With It. Ladies and gentlemen, please greet very warmly Mario Treanor.
Oh!
My name is Rose Bond. How you doing? Person they sent out here to give you time to fetch seats.
Oh,
first thought is, what's my next thing gonna be? I'm not standing around. I want to be in a car chair, a home chair, a restaurant chair, a movie chair. Gotta get to the next seat. Don't want to be disturbed. The seat is a sacred place. You don't want to be disturbed, moved in any way. Would you hand me that, please? I don't want to have to get up. When you're in a theater like this, and you've settled in like you are now, the worst thing is to see somebody coming down your row. Oh, just look at this guy.
Sexual overture to that person. Just say something totally insane. be in the middle of a conversation with somebody, have a thought pop into your head, I could probably kill this guy right now.
Ha ha ha.
why other types of food continue to exist. Why bother? How could they possibly compete with the seamless flow of the Pop-Tart experience? Two in each packet, two slots in the toaster. All right, nothing to think about there. Why two? One's not enough, three's too many. They can't go stale because they were never fresh. But food is a problem. You do think about it. You do feel people have their issues. Everybody has their little issue. I wish I ate more of that. I wish I ate less of that. And you think it's all you. You think it's your mind that I want food. I say food wants you. Food is working on you, trying to get you. That is the secret part of this little equation that we don't talk about. All the little things food does to get your attention. Why is it that you can smell French fries through a foot-thick concrete wall? Why does pizza come to that perfect point, so perfect to bite? The holes in the donuts, the twirling in the pasta, do you think these things happen by accident? Random occurrence, unintentional. Do you think women wear a push-up bra because they like the supportive feeling? These things are coming after you. They're trying to get you. Once food realizes it's food, it has two options, tummy or garbage. There's no other option for food. Everything that's in your stomach at the end of the day, that's the winners. Everything that you eat today, there's the winners. They're signing and going, yeah, we made it! High-five and back-slapping. We're in. Where are we going after this? Let's just enjoy this moment. Who knows what the future holds? We also have this liquid culture that we live in. You see, they give me my little celebrity water here. Make sure you hydrate, Jerry. That's another annoying word, isn't it? Hydrate, make sure you hydrate, make sure you hydrate. You know what can happen to you if you don't hydrate? You can get dehydrated. Which has so far not happened to anyone that anybody knows. Because of the thirst response, which is built into the human species for about 5 million years. Because I'm thirsty, I don't know what to do next. Of course, the business people on TV say, if you feel thirsty, you're already too late. Really? Yes, it's over. Forget the whole thing. You're an empty snakeskin carcass now. Walk over you on the street, crunch, wow, that guy got dehydrated. It is such a challenge now to figure out what to drink. This is the two biggest hassles of daily life. What am I going to eat? What am I going to drink? You go in these mini mart places, you know, it's just trying to think, what are you getting? I don't know. Shut up. I'm going to figure it out. Perceive, I got to feel where I'm at right now. Who I am. What to drink to become who I want to be. You see these commercials for Gatorade? Now where they say you need three Gatorades. Three! To survive! One to prepare, one to perform, one to recover. I just went from the fridge to the couch. How many electrolytes did I lose there? 5-hour energy drink. You ever see that one by the cash register? Tiny little bottle. 5 hours! That's a weird amount of time. This is working 1 to 6. in restaurants. You already have it. They're trying to give you more. Let me fill it up. Warm it up. Top it off. You can lift up a manhole cover. We just made a fresh pot. Would you like some? Coffee's not even in the beverage category. It's in the motivation support group liquid lifestyle experience. You don't drink coffee. You have coffee. That's what you say, right? I'm having my coffee here. Do you mind? Can you give me a minute? I'm having coffee! How do you take your coffee? That's what people say. You take it. Take is a big word. People take sides. Take advantage. If you're a sniper and you have the shot, take them out. Move into these coffee shops, don't they? What are they doing in there? Just why do you think because you bought a cup of coffee you can live here now? Get out! I want to open up a coffee shop called Beat It. Coffee comes in three sizes. Get lost, see you in Instagram. There's too much pride taken in this drink. Get these big coffees, they walk down the street, they hold it out like they won an award. I'd like to thank Juan Valdez for all he did to help me achieve this. I believe I have the right of way here. I haven't very letters. Who's judging your car? The original idea of coffee was a 10-minute break in the middle of 8 hours. We're now drinking 8 hours of coffee, doing 10 minutes. But it's funny to me how coffee has like these two lives that it leads, two separate lives. It has one life in the cup. In the cup, the coffee's like this happy party thing. Everybody around it gets all excited. They're sippy and chirpy and stirry and, you know, they're shaking the little packets. Oh, I want to hear this whole story. And the coffee leaves, the cup enters the human body, and it's not so friendly there. When the coffee gets inside the human body, it's a little angry in there, isn't it? The coffee looks around like, I don't like the way anything's being done in here. I want more talking, more pain, and I want your eyeball hovering 6 inches out in front of your forehead. Large intestine, I want all of that out of here.
Wouldn't that be
all your friends. You know what it comes down to? It's all your friends that want you to get whatever new stupid thing. They go, oh, you gotta get this phone, Jerry. I just got this one. You gotta get this one. This is the best one. Why don't you listen to me? Why don't you leave me alone? I miss phones that you can slam down when you were angry at somebody. I never want to talk to you again the rest of my life. It doesn't even matter what kind of phone you have. All that matters is that you have your phone. You're not going out on a Saturday night without your phone. You ever get halfway somewhere and realize you haven't got your phone? What's the matter? Oh, I forgot the phone. You can use mine. No, I can't. I don't like using other people's phones. I can't deal with the facial screen grease. You know, sometimes people hand you their phone, it looks like a clown was using it. Why is your phone so greasy like that? But then as the day wears on, the battery goes down low and low. Don't you feel like your body's getting tired when the phone's running out? You're just trying to get home to your charger. The call comes in, listen, I don't know how much time I have left. I wish I could take back some of the things I've said. If I go dead on the street, tell everyone I know I'll talk to them tomorrow. Telling you to wait for the beep. Really, the beep is the 21st goddamn century. We're all up to speed on the beep. The Maasai tribes and the African plain know about the beep. They don't leave a message till they hear, nobody, 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 beep! Why are people still telling you to leave your name and number on phone machines? Are these necessary instructions? Anyone getting messages like this is a woman, goodbye. Or he's dead, call me back. What was that? Call the right D, Star 69. All this stuff that we have now, no one gets through to me so I know who the hell it is. Why should you talk to me knowing it's me without me knowing it's you? I should be calling you without you knowing it's me. That was the immediate message. Didn't used to be like that. Used to be, years ago, the phone would ring, somebody in your house would go, oh, get it. You don't hear that anymore. Now the phone rings, people go, nobody knows! Star 69, that was the first phone feature that I thought was weird. They came out with this thing, somebody calls, they hang up. Now we gotta get this guy. Why do we gotta get him? But the Asbury people.
Yes, I know you're here. I'm
surprised you're even paying attention. Blackberry people always hold the blackberry all day long. They do. And then they try and talk to them, but their eye looks like a doll's eye, doesn't it? Yes, I agree with whatever you're saying. Or they just drop out on you. You ever get that? Do we even know what rudeness is anymore? Can I pick up a magazine, hold it in front of your face, and read it while you're talking?
Tweeting. I am tweeting. All right, Dan! Your name is not on the list! Get out of this car! Back out the floor! Get behind your head!
How about trying one goddamn hot tub to start out with? That's too complicated. Who sits in two different tubs? I'm trying to get something. Come on. Who even has two tubs? Unconnected to any plumbing of any kind. All the 5,000-pound cast iron tubs up on a hillside to watch the sunset. Can't figure out why you don't have any energy left for love making. Ask your doctor if you're healthy enough for sexual activity.
Own death.
But here's what I do know. Ladies, I know that your husband wants to make you happy. He wants to do it. He cannot do it. He doesn't know how to do it. Sometimes we do it. We don't know how we did it.
I love the whole guy.
trying to pull a fast one. The tuxedo is worn by the groom to express to his future wife, please enjoy this elegant upscale lifestyle in which you are not going to be living. Wherever you are, where things don't seem completely on the up and up, casinos, auctions, award shows, gentlemen's clubs, ahem, the tuxedo is there to distract from the clamoring, chicanery, and bogosity. That's what the tuxedo was all about. Only the renting of this absurd getup could enhance the sleaziness of the experience. But that is how men think. We flash forward to the court appearance. Your Honor, I couldn't have meant what I said. Those weren't even my clothes. But a wedding is an awful experience. I like being married, but we had a small wedding. I couldn't handle the big blowout of those months, style. That was not for me. And I'm sure there are people here tonight that are planning another one of these hideous experiences. If you are, do not woo, do not applaud. Just sit quietly in the dark. There is something you need to know about this wedding that your family will not tell you, friends will not tell you, only I. Your strange little TV friend. I might be the only person you know that can tell you the complete, straight-up, honest truth, which is this. Nobody wants to go to your wedding! Party. If you were going to plan a good party, would you first invite all the oldest people you know so you can sit there watching them eat in the disgusting way that they do? Why do old people eat so badly? They have the most experience at it. What age is it when you can no longer feel this food on your face? There's a piece of food on your lap.
Always say, oh no, I can't. I'm like, I can't.
jumpsuit and a wooden stick with a nail in it, too.
I don't even want it.